Hi, welcome to my studio. I'm Sarah, and today I'm continuing my series of Star Wars drawings and painting with gouache for the first time. So I got these Arteza gouache paints for Christmas a couple of years ago, but have not really gotten the chance to use them. I'm really excited to try gouache out. If you have any tips, feel free to comment them. I can use all the help I can get. Before jumping into the painting, I swatched all the colors. The neon ones aren't as opaque, which I find interesting. I haven't had that much experience with watercolors. I've mostly used acrylics if I paint at all. So I guess I'm halfway there. Gouache is supposed to be like a mix between acrylics and watercolors, right? Maybe not. Trying to figure out how much water to add was really tricky. I kept adding too much water and washing out what paint I had just put down. I did kind of figure out what different amounts of water will do to the paint, what makes it more like acrylics, and what makes it more like watercolors. Prompt number 5 is part of your favorite planet. There's so many planets in the Star Wars universe to choose from, but I'm gonna have to say Lothal because it's the home planet of one of my favorite characters, Ezra Bridger. This was definitely a trust the process painting for me. At first, the sky looked like something a little kid would paint, but as I added more to it, I don't think it turned out that bad. Again, kept adding too much water and messing up what I had already painted. The thing about gouache is when you add more paint or more water to the paper, it reactivates what paint is already there, which can be helpful for blending. Or it can mess up everything, again. It is cool to see how gouache blends, although it took me a little bit to figure it out. I haven't painted clouds recently, but blending the paint with a circular motion seemed to do the trick pretty well to get that fluffy cloud look. Adding this darker color was a mistake. I was trying to mute the purple a bit, but I added too much black, and then I added too much water again, so I ended up having to sort of rework the whole cloud. Which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but it shows I really need to work on my color mixing. Color theory in general is something I want to work on. One thing I do like about this piece is that the purple of the sky and the yellow grass I paint later complement each other. Another reason why I love Lothal, the color scheme is so pretty. Adding more water to gouache lightens the opacity, and I used that to blend the sky out so it fades into the horizon. This much water made it behave a lot more like watercolors, so it mixed more like watercolors too, giving the sky a cool effect. Another reason I love Lothal is because the stone pillars? Mountains? What are these things? Hang on. So they're just called stone spires. These things are so unique and the fields are so peaceful. What's your favorite Star Wars planet? Comment down below! For the spires that are farther away, I watered down the paint to give a sense of depth. The atmosphere causes things that are farther away to appear lighter, like mountains, which gives that sense of depth. For Lothal, you can see very far away, so the horizon of the sky and of the land sort of blend into each other. Painting or drawing, natural looking grass is definitely not my strong suit. I have a hard time making it not look uniform and actually look like natural, random blades of grass. It probably didn't help that my brush was not small enough too. Layering lots of varying colors and values on top of each other helped. You don't have to paint every single blade of grass as long as you show the form of it. That is, focusing on the shadows and highlights. It was a lot of fun to figure out where to place certain strokes to achieve that. It's so satisfying to peel away the washi tape, especially when the paper doesn't rip and none of the paint bleeds through, just a nice, clean edge. Obviously, I am by no means an expert when it comes to gouache, but I hope you learned something along with me. Thank you so much for watching, and if you haven't already, check out the first parts of this series. May the Force be with you.